can you lose weight and keep it off? Well, the research states potentially not. Only 5% of people who lose weight due to exercise and dieting regimens are able to keep that weight off over a period of time. So what does this mean for the other 95% of us? Is dieting futile? And why is it so hard to manage our weight? To discuss this in more detail and look at some tactics for maintaining weight loss, I'm going to discuss this with Dr. Gina Cleo. Dr. Gina is a registered dietitian, a nutritionist, and has spent years investigating and studying the science underlying weight loss and weight management. Gina, thanks so much for coming here today.
Thanks, Christian. It's great to be here.
Most people get heavier with age, and we hear a lot about diets and exercise regimens as a way to successfully lose weight, but research shows that most people simply return to their original size. Mm. The status quo, therefore, is to put any weight you lose back on again. So, Gina, why is it so hard to maintain weight loss over a period of time?
This is definitely the most frustrating part of any weight loss journey. And we find that 95% of people who lose weight will then regain that weight again. So it can be such a difficult journey. And we do know, though, that the majority of people who are regaining that weight are just simply eating too much for what their body needs. And we often think that it's a lack of willpower or motivation, but there are actually a number of physiological effects that take place in the body when we lose weight.
So what are these internal effects?
So our body has a predefined level of fat stores. It's what it calls the set point or the ideal point. So when we lose weight, we also stimulate a series of physiological responses, which are designed to get us back to this ideal weight. And that's the weight that our bodies like. And so what happens is we have an increase in our hunger hormones and a decrease in the hormones that make us feel full. So straight away, we're losing weight, but we're actually getting hungrier. So we eat more and then we regain that weight again.
The science behind this is patchy, a little bit contradictory, but when we lose weight, it seems like the fat cells don't necessarily die off. They simply shrink in size. And so when we're dieting, we look thinner, but it's very easy then to refill those with fat, that when we get off our health regimen or we stop dieting, they can very easily refill. Now, one thing that I find when I exercise a lot is that I feel like I've deserved it and I'm more likely to eat a lot more junk food or extra portions of food. Is this just me or is this a common phenomenon?
No, you are definitely not alone. This is a very common thing that I see. And I've actually called this the halo effect. So we exercise and then we feel like, yes, I've deserved to have extra food or food that I wouldn't normally be eating. And we also really overestimate how many calories we burn during a workout. So in one study, for example, the participants had lost between 200 and 300 calories during their workout. But when they were asked how many calories they think they burned, they estimated about 800 calories. And so as a consequence, we're overcompensating and eating a lot more than they needed to.
What about motivation then?
Yeah, another factor with weight regain is absolutely motivation. So when we're losing weight, we might seek the advice of a dietitian or a health coach, for example. But we don't continue consulting them when we're just maintaining the weight. You know, we've achieved our goal and we've lost our weight. And so then we stop seeing those health professionals. And so we lose the accountability and we lose that support system. And therefore, we're not as motivated to maintain the weight.
Does self-control then have anything to do with it?
Absolutely. Actually, self-control is one of the main reasons that people regain their weight. So think of self-control like a muscle, and the more you use it, the more exhausted that it gets. And self-control is a resource that depletes throughout the day. And any stressful type of situation can deplete your self-control. It could be bad traffic, a difficult exam, or an argument that you had with someone, for example. So as your self-control depletes, you have less of it to then be on a really strict diet or exercise regimen. And so you just throw your hands up in the air and go, oh, I don't want to do this anymore. And you end up eating whatever you can reach for.
So the focus seems to be consistently on dieting, whereas actually having a long-term plan for health weight maintenance after you lose that weight is just or even more important. What do you recommend then as a way to maintain any weight loss?
I always recommend that people look at changing their habits rather than depending on their self-control. So habits are the things that you do automatically in your day that you're not completely conscious of. So that could be things like brushing your teeth or tying your shoelace, putting your seatbelt on in the car, you know, the things that you do automatically. So we form habits by firstly making small, manageable changes. And that could be something that I always say, do something so small that you can't say no to doing it. And then repeating those until they become like second nature, that you don't even have to really consciously think about doing them anymore.
So by making habits that burn calories or habits that help you with that weight loss, it then removes the self-control, the motivation of always having to do something.
Yes, exactly.
Thank you, Gina. Well, I really appreciate you coming. It's been very helpful.
Thanks for having me. It's been great to be here.
Now, that was meant to be the end of the video, but as I was editing and listening to what Gina was saying, I had a couple of extra questions about some tips and tactics that she recommended to maintain that weight loss over a period of time, and one or two other things that I'd love to keep discussing in more detail. So I asked her to come back and talk with us again. So Gina, the big worry is if dieting isn't working for that many people, if 95% of people are going to simply put that weight back on again, then is dieting a sham? What's the point of it?
The thing is, every single diet is packaged differently. The low carbohydrate diet gives different promises and is packaged differently to, say, a ketogenic diet or a paleo diet or a fasting diet. And so those diets can work in the short term, but they don't offer that long-term benefit. And unless a diet is specifically promising long-term outcomes, then it's not necessarily a sham because, you know, short-term it can be effective for weight loss.
A major question I had as well was you mentioned that making things habitual no longer need the self-control and the motivation to do them. So what are some examples of healthy habits that people can do to maintain weight loss?
So healthy habits can be things like eating from a smaller plate or walking, taking the stairs instead of the escalator, or standing up for 10 minutes in every hour just to be more conscious of being more active. So it's really just the little things that you could do in your day that then add up over the week or over the months.
In summary, listening to Gina and hearing about the most recent research, why it's hard to keep any weight we lose off, is starting to make more sense. We're bombarded by weight loss strategies and diets every day. New age, exciting eating plans or interventions, with many of them working quite well. We're not against dieting, and in fact, watching and considering what you eat is vitally important and healthy. The problem is that we rarely put into place tactics for maintaining any weight lost over long periods of time. We rush into diets and exercise plans with enthusiasm, drive, and motivation. Yet, as Gina described, over time, these attributes wear thin and we end up back in our normal routines. So what can we do? Well, in the long term, weight maintenance is far more important than weight loss. What's the point of putting all that effort and sweat into losing weight if it's just going to rebound straight away? Now, as soon as possible, or before you start dieting, put into place strategies that don't rely upon motivation and self-control. Strategies that you can work with in the long term. Gina's advice and research finds that making good practices into habits is a fantastic way to start. Whether it's standing up for 10 minutes every hour, or ensuring that you habitually pack an apple or healthy snack each day. Make your hard work count and focus on maintaining any lost weight over the long term. You'll be more active, you'll feel better about yourself, and one step closer to having a happy, healthy body.